Welcome to a Q&A about data science in Australia. Over the past few months, I've gotten lots of questions about immigration, data science degrees, and lifestyle in Australia. So today, I'll be answering your hottest questions. All of the questions are going to be timestamped in the description below, so feel free to skip around. I'm Samanve, and I'm a data scientist living in Sydney, Australia. So all the questions I'll be answering today, I've gotten through my comment section or my Instagram. So make sure to follow me on Instagram for any future Q&A. So the first question is, how did you come to Australia? So I came to Australia when I was 11 years old, and I did my high schooling in a small town called Hervey Bay, which is 300 kilometers north of Brisbane. Once I finished my high school education, I moved to Sydney for my university degree, which brings me on to the next question, which is, how did you become a data scientist? For anyone that hasn't watched my video about how I went from engineering to data science, here's a quick recap. So I went to University of Sydney to study aerospace engineering out of a passion for space technologies. But towards the end of the degree, I quickly realized that I really wanted to learn skill sets that would allow me to work in multiple industries and solve problems across a wide variety of fields. And during that time, I found data science. Once I graduated, I was lucky enough to find a job in a small 50-person startup. And my first job title was actually data analyst. But given how small the team was, I got to do everything from back-end development to data engineering and also data science. And if you're someone that is looking to start their career right now after their education, I would recommend joining a small company to begin with, because that's where you'll be wearing lots of hats and you'll really be pushed to your limit. And that's the best environment to be learning very quickly, which is what you should be optimizing for rather than the size of your paycheck. And if you want to learn a little bit more about the details of how I got my first job, then be sure to check out this video. On to the next question, which is, what is the best way to get started with data science? So there's many ways of getting started with data science. So if you're just graduating from school, you could consider doing a Bachelor of Data Science or a Master of Data Science if you're graduating with a degree, or you could also consider doing a Bachelor of Computer Science, because that way you can keep your options open as much as possible. If you've already got a STEM degree, such as a Bachelor of Science or a Bachelor of Engineering in a given field, you could get away with self-learning data science courses online. So this way you'll be learning majority of your data science skills on the job. And that's exactly the path that I followed when I got lucky with my first job and I landed in a small startup. And a while back, I made a 3-month roadmap to learning data science on your own. And if that's something that's interesting to you, then I'll leave a video link right here. Next question is, how different is data science research versus data science in the industry? Let's take the example of doing research at a master's level or a PhD level. In both of those cases, your research has to be novel. You'll be innovating in a section of a field. So let's say you're researching in neural networks. An example research topic could be researching whether there's a possibility of improving backpropagation to make it more computationally time efficient. And majority of PhDs and masters tend to be very mathematically heavy. So you'll be using a lot of equations on a daily basis and focusing on a more theoretical and academic approach to machine learning. Quite a lot of data science roles in research organizations like Google Brain or DeepMind require the applicants to have PhDs. And these roles will be working on the cutting edge of machine learning algorithms. For example, one of the recent breakthroughs at DeepMind was them training a reinforcement learning algorithm to control the plasma in the recent nuclear fission experiment that happened a couple of weeks ago. So as you can see, you'll be working on things at a very grand scale. But on the flip side, because you're in such a cutting edge research, it's possible that you won't see the applications for many years down the line. Data science in the commercial industry is very different. Your main job in the industry is to solve commercial problems using data science. And this means using the best algorithm for the job. And more often than not, we opt to use simpler algorithms than more complicated ones. So in many cases, most industries won't be using anything more complicated than tree-based algorithms, such as XGBoost, or random forest, because the incentive in the industry is to be able to explain the algorithms to stakeholders. So you could say that data science in the industry is more pragmatic and practical from an application perspective. And if you're more curious about what data science in the industry looks like, then be sure to check out this video. Master of Data Science or Master of IT? Usually the people that ask this question, they're coming from a computer science background. For all of those, I usually recommend a Master of IT. Why? Because you want to keep your options open in case you want to try out other software engineering professions, such as going into cybersecurity, web development, DevOps, or even data science, because a lot of Master of IT courses will have a specialization for data science. So if you do have an inkling that you might prefer to explore other software engineering options or explore other careers, then Master of IT would be the degree for you. I'd recommend the Master of Data Science degree if you're hell-bent on doing data science, because that'll give you exposure to more of the advanced maths and statistic units that you need to thrive in data science. Which is the best university for Master of Data Science in Australia, and how much does it cost? A while back, I made a video just on this topic, which is me covering all of the Master of Data Science courses in Australia, and I think it amounted to something like 22 different courses. So be sure to check out that video, and I've also got a link in that description which points you to a Notion website which has the breakdown of all of those different courses and the fee structure involved with those courses. So it'll help you make a better decision as to where to go for your Master of Data Science degree. But if I were to just quickly summarize, so the best Master of Data Science degree I found through that research was the Master of Data Science degree at the University of Melbourne, and typically these Master of Data Science degrees can cost anywhere from $30,000 per year to $50,000 per year. And they can range from 1.5 years to 2 years in length of time. Next question is, can you get a PR after getting a Master of Data Science degree? The short answer is yes. So a couple of you have highlighted that data scientist is not a profession on the skilled occupations list, which is this list that Australia has, which determines whether or not you're eligible for the PR pathway. So whilst data scientist is not actually on the list, there are other professions like programmer, business analyst, or data analyst. So sometimes you will be able to get an employer to sponsor you under those professions, and which will allow you to qualify for this PR. But this is not official advice, so be sure to talk to your migrant lawyer before you pursue these pathways. So the next question is, what is the best university for Bachelor of Data Science? So this is something I haven't really touched on just yet, because I wasn't sure how many Bachelor of Data Science degrees are actually popping up. So I'll be sure to do a more complete video on this matter, just like I did with the Master of Data Science degree. But I do know a couple of viewers that are going to the University of New South Wales and doing their Bachelor of Data Science and Decisions degree. This is a 3-year degree that teaches you all the basics of data science and also gives you opportunities to be doing internships throughout the degree. What are the salaries like in data science in Australia? So right now the average salary for a data scientist and machine learning engineer is around $110,000. But in most cases, the graduate salary isn't that high. So you're gonna be starting off a lot lower than this, and the salary changes based on your seniority level and experience. I made a video on the data scientist salaries a couple of months ago, so be sure to check that out. So the last question is, what is the cost of living in Australia? So I'll give you a rough guide as to the cost of living in capital cities like Sydney and Melbourne, and these are the cities I've lived in before. If you're on your own, you're looking at anywhere from $1,500 to $2,000 for renting. So this is a studio apartment or a one-bedroom apartment. And for families, it can be a little bit different based on which suburb you choose to live in. And add another $1,000 a month for groceries, bills, transport, insurance, and all of the other necessities. So roughly you're looking at around $2,000 to $3,000 per month just for your basic utilities and needs. I know the numbers are a little bit rough, but I'll be sure to make a separate video that tackles the issue in a little bit more detail. That's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this data science Q&A, and be sure to add me on Instagram so that you can post me more questions to ask for the next Q&A. Hope you have a great day and night, and I'll see you next time.